Good morning. Jim Chalmers will become the first Treasurer in nearly two decades to hand down a back-to-back budget surplus. He'll announce the federal government is banking $9.3 billion when he gets to his feet tonight in Parliament. Live 2 political reporter Ben Downey in Canberra. Ben, good morning. There are still some surprises to be revealed.
Good morning, Anne. Yes, and Jim Chalmers nearly gave some away, telling reporters this morning there will be more cost of living relief, this time aimed at those who won't benefit from the tax cut policy. So that's those earning less than $18,000 a year. Think students, retirees, low-income earners as well. It's widely tipped there will be a raise to the age pension and a raise to youth allowance, as well as Commonwealth rent assistance and energy bill relief like last year's relief package that the ABS confirmed put downward pressure on inflation. We can also expect spending on paid parental leave, new housing, funding to combat violence against women and billions to help students pay off debt and fund practical placements. However, the $9.3 billion surplus could fall into deficit in the years ahead, with falling commodity prices, a softening jobs market, and what the government describes as unavoidable costs associating with an ageing population. That's ballooning NDIS and healthcare costs and overhauling the MyGov portal. But the Treasurer's first priority is tackling inflation.
We are asked to strike a series of fine balances in this budget. Primarily cost of living and fighting inflation, but also making sure that we're strengthening Medicare and building more homes, reforming our universities and strengthening our skills base.
We've seen two budgets so far from this government. Both have completely failed to beat, to tame the cost of living crisis that we continue to see in this country.
The Treasurer has staked his credibility against the Reserve Bank, predicting inflation will be back under control by Christmas. The budget will be handed down tonight at 7:30. Anne.
Ben Downey in Canberra. Thank you, Ben.
Joining me now is author and journalist Justin Smith and journalist Suzanne Mostyn. Morning to both of you.
Morning.
Justin, economics professor and former Treasury official Dr. Stephen Hamilton says cost of living support for low-income Aussies comes with a cost for other Aussies. Is the Treasurer in a bit of a no-win situation when he hands down the budget?
Absolutely. They all seem to be, don't they? I love these couple of days, you know, before the budget. It's always economists at 20 paces, isn't it? But it sort of shows you that the deficit and surplus talk is not kind of always what it's cracked up to be. That, you know, politicians absolutely love to campaign on it, but we've got a surplus here. We've got a Treasurer who's putting a surplus forward. And yet people say, well, it's going to have upward pressure on inflation. And yet when we're in a deficit, we had upward pressure on inflation. We had rising interest rates. So, you know, and of course, as a person who is not an economist, there always seems to be a great deal of politics and, and guesswork at play here, and we're sort of sitting back and just going, gee, I hope that guy's right and I hope that guy's wrong.
There's a lot of guys and women here saying, well, I think this and I think this. So, Suze, we've got the Treasurer and the Treasury, all the boffins in the department saying this is going to reduce inflation. Then we've got a bunch of economists here and there in the papers this morning saying, no, I think the opposite. Most of us are not economists, so how do we work out what's going to happen here?
Well, like all good amateur prognosticators, I went to my crystal ball last night.
Yes.
I went to my neighbour, my postie, the tarot cards, and then finally the easy one, the magic eight ball. And I shook that thing and it said, time will tell. And I think that's the story. I mean, we're all looking for how it affects our individual family hip pockets, aren't we? Mm. And, of course, people want to see. They're not so much worried about inflation because to them it's, what is this thing called inflation? They're saying, will there be an interest rate cut? So will the budget budget? Will it budge that percentage for them paying their mortgages? Mm. Look, I mean, I heard Mark Riley say over the weekend that this is a Goldilocks budget. They can't be too hard, too soft. It's got to be just right. But on a seesaw, as I see it more, trying to find the balance, it's going to be tough.
Yeah, and, you know, those headlines about the surplus, I wonder how many Australians think, oh, what do I get out of that? Does that mean much for
That's
me?
That's it for me.
Yeah. Joining me now is Shadow Treasurer Angus Taylor. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
So let's get this straight. Jim Chalmers says the budget forecast shows inflation could fall to that target band that we all want, 2 to 3% by Christmas. It's more optimistic than the Reserve Bank is offering. Treasury, full of independence from the government, all those independent boffins, also says inflation will be down by the end of the year. Are they all wrong?
Well, the Reserve Bank set the warning bells off, Nat, that inflation is going to be stronger for longer, and we've seen it's been stronger for longer, much stronger than forecast expected. And Australia has amongst the most persistent inflation of any country in the advanced world. And that's not what we want to see. We need to see a budget that tames this homegrown domestic inflation, which has been raging, continues to rage, has been above expectations. Every Australian household knows the pain they are feeling from an extended period of higher prices and higher interest rates. Yeah. The last two budgets have been flops. They haven't delivered the outcome that we need to get back to that target range quickly. But we can't afford another flop. We need a budget that delivers on this. That is far and away the most important test for the budget.
So the Treasurer says we've got it, and the RBA hasn't seen what he's got yet. So that sounds good, doesn't it?
Well, I think the RBA was very clear. They're sending off the warning bells, and many other economists are too. We've had economist after economist coming out in recent days saying that we've got a continuing inflation problem in this country.
So what
and
would you do?
It hasn't been addressed.
Let's say you're Treasurer tomorrow. Yeah. What would you do? Would you
That's the right question, Nat. The first and most important thing is just as households are really having to work hard to balance their budgets, not just for this year, but right out into the future, so too does the government. And if the government does that, it takes pressure off household budgets. It's a very simple message. Economists are all telling us. And right now, we're seeing a government that looks as though it's going to deliver a budget with red ink all the way out into the future.
Yeah, so what
That's
would you cut again?
Need.
Exactly, just so we understand exactly, because, you know, cost of living crisis, people are saying, I can't afford to pay my rent. This is really, really hard. Mince is even, you know, high at the supermarkets. Yeah. What exactly would you cut in this budget?
Well, we've already opposed $45 billion of spending that this government has committed to through the parliament over recent times. But there's also a lot of waste that needs to be cut. I mean, we saw a failed referendum that cost $450 million.
Yeah, so we're not going to talk about the past. We just want to know what would you cut?
But the Treasurer has committed to a $40 million spin unit because he can't get inflation down, so he wants to spin it. Well, that's not how you spend money in a cost of living crisis. We've seen $20,000 of extra spending from this budget for the average Australian household. And I tell you what, Nat, I don't think there's many households out there feeling as though they're seeing the benefit from that. We need to see a government that lives within its means, just as households are having to live within their means, and that ensures we get downward pressure on inflation. We make sure we're on a pathway to prosperity. That's not what we've seen from the last two budgets. It's what we've got to see from this one.
Okay. If there was one nice thing you'd say about the Treasurer today, what would that be?
Oh, well, I mean, I wish him luck. I want to see lower inflation in this country. He's had a couple of goes. We need to see success on that. Every Australian wants to see this cost of living crisis beaten, and they want the Treasurer to hand down a budget that does that.
Oh, that was kind of nice. Okay. Thank you very much for joining us today.
If you don't want to wade through the 1,000 pages, we'll do that for you to see if you're eligible for any cost of living relief. There are things you can do to sharpen your household budget now. ING's Matt Bowen has some tips for us this morning. Matt, what do we need to do to get some more money back in our pockets? Everyone needs this now.
Good morning, Eddie. Well, it used to be much more simple, didn't it? We could just reach between the couch cushions and find a couple of bucks that fell out of Dad's pocket. It's harder these days, but I'm going to give you something you can do this evening while the Treasurer is announcing the budget papers to Parliament. That's pull out your banking app and search for all those unused subscriptions or direct debits that come out. We did some research last year. Aussies are wasting up to $100 a month or $1,200 a year on unused subscriptions. That's entertainment, that's gym memberships, it's those apps that kind of have those purchases built in. So it's really important to connect with your app. Check out those things that you're wasting money on, and it can seriously add to the household budget. Whilst you're in there, also take a look at your savings interest rates. In a high interest rate environment, it's also very important to make sure that your hard-earned dollars are earning money as well, Eddie.
Yes, some really great tips. Thank you, Matt.